Godzilla
his skin is like horse.
Yeah,
didn't you see he has lasers and not bullets?
Have you seen? Yeah, but that's likely like radiation, and Godzilla gets stronger with radiation.
Wait, hey guys, check this out.
Psychology experiment pays $100.
It was kind of sketchy though. It doesn't really say what we'll be doing.
I think I work that day anyways. So.
Yeah, but $100.
Well, I'm not doing this alone, so I'm gonna sign you guys up anyways.
But I have work.
Attention. I'll be calling in each of you one at a time. The doctor will be right with you. The doctor will see you now.
Oh, hey, come on in. Let's get started. This is really quite easy. Just a second. Okay. This is really pretty easy. I think what you have to do is just answer quickly, honestly. A couple of questions is really no big deal. So first things first, what's your name?
Nate.
Brooklyn.
Aaron.
Karen.
Scott.
Mona.
Aiden.
Connor.
Nick.
Matt.
Luke.
Cam.
Eric.
What's your favorite color?
Blue.
I like blue.
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 Yellow.
What fills you with joy?
Bakugan or Beyblades?
Dungeons and Dragons.
Bare knuckle brawling. Just about everything.
Is there anything that really annoys you?
Eric.
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 Eric. No, nothing.
What is your biggest fear?
Being buried alive.
Drowning.
Steve.
Who's that?
My dad.
Probably people not liking me.
Nothing.
Losing control.
Doctors. Sorry.
Probably butterflies.
Dark spaces.
Being abandoned.
Heights.
The dark.
Biggest fear is not being accepted for who I am. You know, I like mac and cheese and ketchup. And I don't feel like that's, you know, weird. And also, I like putting one sock on, then a shoe. Not both socks and both shoes, so you know. Don't be, you have to do what other people do.
Alright, y'all can come over here and get your checks.
That was ridiculously easy.
Yeah, that really was.
That was nice.
$100?
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Whatever. Is it?
I'm gonna buy so many bucks.
Wow.
With this evil contraption, I will destroy the world! Please work. Yes, 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 I freaking rock! No one can stop me, not even Captain Honey Badger, Hilliard's number one vigilante.
Stop right there, you freaking evildoer.
No, you're too late, something. Ah, God, I already screwed it up.
No, it's okay. Just, why don't you go back, try again faster. You can do it, I believe in you.
Oh, I can't.
Yes, you can.
No, he can't. Captain Honey Badger? Dude, come on, this one's mine. Don't you have more important villains to take care of?
Important.
Look, kid, scram. Look here, Professor Brains.
No, dude. What the hell, dude? You can't just walk over us little guys like this. Just because you took out Dr. Chaos doesn't mean...
I said scram, kid. Jesus, you freak. All right, Professor Brains. Where were we? Popsicle sticks!
Little Gerd, let me come in. It's time for Film Fest season again, And I'll huff, and I'll puff, and you'll let me in!
Some weird neighbors. Hey.
Hey girl, what's up?
The weirdest thing just happened.
What?
So I was taking a nap and then I just heard these loud noises and then I looked out the window and there was this weird person wearing a horse mask with like all neon clothes.
Oh yeah, my uncle used to get paid for that, but like he's done with it.
Hold on, I'm getting a text.
Who's it from?
It was from an unknown number that said come to the basement.
Are you gonna do it?
Of course I'm gonna go.
I was gonna say, there's like nothing wrong with that.
Yeah, it's totally normal.
I mean, it's happened to me like plenty of times.
Surprise!
Who are you? Okay. Still not getting anything. Sally?
But wait.
I'm you!
Wait, but then who am I?
Was good, but you got the money?
Yeah, dog.
No, bro, it's the cops. My mom catches me again, she's gonna kill me, bro.
Don't worry. I can talk to the cops. Don't worry about it, I got you. X gon' give it to you. Wait for you to get it on your own. X gon' deliver to you. Knock, knock, open up the door, it's real. With the non-stop pop out, I'm stainless steel. Afternoon, boys. I'm Officer Rex Johnson. This is Officer Cabal Nabob.
We got a call that you boys were loitering and making your neighbors uncomfortable.
We're gonna have to ask you boys to leave right away.
What? This is the third complaint this week. Well, shouldn't we bring them in?
Nah, they're just hanging out like kids do. We were like them once, remember?
No worries, officer. We'll be out here in just a minute.
Yeah, man. It's not like we were selling anything or anything like that. Wait a minute. What's in that bag?
Oh, all right. You're definitely coming with us right now.
What are you two's names, anyway?
You don't need to know about that. We talked to you guys 3 times this week. Come on, tell us.
Alexis Jefferson.
Is that a girl's name? Alright, okay, that was good. What's your name now, sweet cheeks, huh? Jessica or something?
Lund Dahlgren.
Dahlgren? From Rocky?
Yeah, I mean, kind of. My dad was a big fan of the live-action He-Man movie.
What? Whoa, that movie was awesome.
I don't care, bro. Awful movie or not, that's a badass name right there.
Well, we had to bring you two in.
Crap. I forgot my handcuffs at the station. Think I might have some duct tape left in the trunk from last night. Cabal, did you move my duct tape?
What? This should be in there. It's right here.
Okay.
Oh no.
Well, snap.
What? We had to get them.
Dang, dude. What happened to you?
Coyotes! I'm not being about 2 eighths grams of any of your pizza!
Buddy, calm down. We can take this edge off right now.
That was our last straw. We're gonna get fired. My wife's gonna kill me.
Shh, buddy. Just take it easy.
No.
Where did everyone go?
What?
What the hell, bro?
What's going on here, bro?
Guys, everyone that's here right now is here last night. They need to know what's going on.
Shut up.
Guys, it's the Illuminati, I'm telling you. Look,
there's
a triangle right here.
No, guys, look at these. I'm telling you, it's gotta be the aliens. Yeah. Look at these pictures. Look at these. They're here.
I lost my gym partner, bros. Who's gonna be my spotter on Max Out Day?
Is that actually all you care about? Seriously?
The one day I come to school.
This isn't happening.
Oh my god, we're gonna get probed.
The government is clearly behind this. Chemtrails. Honestly. First the frogs. Now us.
No, Nate's right. It's aliens.
It's obviously aliens.
No, there's triangles everywhere.
You're going to get thrown.
Hey! You guys are too busy arguing. You didn't even notice all the people were gone.
You guys are so dumb.
Everyone, sit down and let's figure this out.
All right, let's go back. What did you guys all do when you left the experiment last night?
Well, Brooke made a new friend.
Hey, isn't that Connor from school?
Yeah, I don't want to see that tool today, though.
I think we should go talk to him. I
thought we were going to hang out at the park.
Yeah!
Connor?
Hey, you come to get a souvenir?
Why would I want a souvenir?
I just did 50 pull-ups.
Well, I can do that.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Need a lift up?
I think I'm good, thanks. How many was that?
73.
Oh, sweet, that's a new record. Hey, you ready to go?
Why don't you go hang out with your new best friend, Connor?
Buffalo soldier in the heart of America, Baratta from
Hamburgers? You let a girl beat you? I'm still bigger than you, Twig. What did you idiots do last night?
Well, I started a new band.
No, you didn't, dude. You quit our band.
You were trying to ruin it.
You left me. All I wanted was fanny packs.
Well, I wanted trench coats.
Yo, guys, just tell the story.
All right, well, we were having the coolest, excellent, radicalist band practice ever.
Do! Time machine! Do! Time machine!
Get me out!
Time machine!
Get me out!
It's all fake!
Do!
Time machine!
Do!
Time machine!
Get me out!
Time machine!
Get me out!
It's all fake!
Thank you.
We are Car Bomb Speed Date.
And that was Funhouse.
Dude, that was sweet. We're gonna be better than Zeppelin.
Jimmy who?
Dude, all we need are outfits now.
All right.
Fanny packs.
Trench coats?
I'm keeping us warm. Fanny packs?
Yeah, I could keep my picks in there. I could throw them to the crowd.
Dude, that's stupid.
You're stupid.
Eric and I are starting our own band.
Dude, Eric sucks. Just look at him.
Alright, maybe Eric sucks, maybe he can't play an instrument, but he loves trench coats. And that's good enough for me. Our new band is going to be called the Old Bomb Turks, and it's going to be amazing.
Come on, Nick, the band! Nick...
nice day we're having. Nice to meet you. Have a nice day. I'll just be going. Screw it.
I think you will screw this. You got my titles.
Huh? What am I doing holding this bucket?
I put it in your hand when we were looking. Now, speaking of looking.
Look into the bucket.
What did you just do? Nothing up my sleeve.
Thank you.
Where did you get these guns? When did you have time to do that? I can't pull my arm back out.
Dummy, I had these handcuffs in my pocket the whole time. I attached them to your arm when you weren't paying attention.
Ow!
I'm Mindy Mallett, and I'm the founder of Sunrise Sanctuary.
I'm Janet Bland, and I'm the volunteer operations manager.
This was something I always wanted to do, was have a sanctuary for animals and farm animals specifically. And when we moved to Ohio, we bought the property and built the barns before the house. And just, you know, with the plan in mind to open a sanctuary.
It's to take in abused or neglected animals, mostly farm animals, but we take some domestic, just because cats got, you know, dumped so much, and there's all those shelters are so full.
With the birds, if you count all the birds separately, there's about 160.
They all got a story. Curly has probably got the most unique story. Curly came from a gentleman in Cincinnati, did permaculture, and he had the goats at a cemetery to eat the weeds, and he put them in electric fence at night so they would be safe. And another gentleman brought a dog in to train it to fight and sicked it on each goat individually. It broke Curly's spine and pelvis. Killed her twin sister and two other goats and maimed the other goats in the pen. She's here, she's in a wheelchair when we can supervise her, because if you walk out the gate, she flips herself because she's spoiled. And so her probably, her story is probably the most unique of what we have right now. You know, baby Nathan, the one that just passed away recently, he was in that truck wreck in Xenia, where like 1,200 piglets were killed in the crash. And he was the only rescued one. The rest of them, of course, went on to their destination. But we went searching for piglets because after the truck crash and 1,200 piglets.
No, it's actually 2,200, wasn't it?
Well, they had 2,200 on the truck, but 1,200 were killed. Okay. And then the rest escaped into the woods, so they were searching for them, but we were searching to save them, you know, and it was horrific. I mean, just...
But I guess he had a heart defect from his whole upbringing, you know, yeah, inbreeding and whatever.
How old was he?
A year and a half.
Yeah,
he was young, you know, but... But he lived a life, because that was the happiest pig I ever did in my life. Little Miracle fell off a slaughter truck. That most of them, like at Farm Sanctuary and stuff, live about 6 or 7 years.
Yeah. See, they're bred to be so big that they eventually, their legs give out or they develop spinal problems, you know. So, I mean, probably if they weren't bred for meat, they would have a longer lifespan. But just like the white turkeys, you know, they're bred for the big breasts.
But their organs don't know to get any bigger.
Right.
Even though they breed the body to be bigger, the organs don't know, so the organs are working like double time. You know, we won't let them suffer or anything if it's long term. No, if we know they're going to get better, that's different. But, you know, you have to try to correct what you can of it. You know, you want to have as long as good a life as they can. We believe in quality of life. So. Try to, you know, get people to mingle with these animals, meet them, know them, have a face to them, and just choose more compassionate living.
I realize they have a personality. Let me roll it to you.
I think for us, because we live it with the animals too, I mean, I think we can help maybe turn around more people than maybe an ordinary person, because we don't show the horror of it. We show these guys have personality and they love you and they care and they want attention just like a dog.
Guess who's back? Steve. You still doing this?
Andre. Oh, for sure. Yeah. Check me out. Still Dre Day. AK. Though I've grown a lot, can't keep it home a lot. Cause my flow. I want a drink.
No, I want a drink.
Dance battle.
Okay.
Oh, I want a drink.
No, I want a drink.
Dance battle. I want a drink. No! No!
What's up? You like some food?
Okay.
Hi, I'm Tawny.
Well, your night wasn't as bad as mine. I was trying to paint.
It's not much of a painting.
Yours sucked too. It was just a bunch of lines.
What do you guys think? What?
I don't get it.
That square is red. It's not even blue.
Yeah, your vision's way off.
Okay, well, what do you guys have?
Well, mine's more meaningful.
Nope, hate it.
You don't even get it.
That doesn't even mean anything. Mine, however, shows how the wealthy try to influence our mind.
Hate it.
Wow, you guys are a bunch of weenies. Your night sucked. Our night was lit as AF.
Off went the heroes, not a care in the world except for the rocks in their boots. Mona, valiant and cunning. Aiden, strong and steadfast. Luke, quick and stealthy. Nate, some sort of wizard?
Eric, I'm a mage!
Oh, right. Approached by a traveler down the path.
No.
Stupid.
A dragon flies overhead.
Shit. Do not. No, we don't have the budget for that.
You guys come across a campsite. Do you want to investigate?
No, guys, I think that's about
it. Actually, that sounds like a great idea. We're going to find some useful things there.
Yeah. Okay, let's do it.
We're rich!
Yeah, I'm rich!
Hey! That's my stuff!
Charge!
Yeah!
Ah!
Yeah!
Woo! Oh, hell yeah!
Got him!
Can we set up camp in the Ogre's campsite?
Yes, you may.
You just want to do that?
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. We'll do that.
You guys set up camp, but your stomachs are grumbling. It is time to find food.
Can we just eat Eric?
Sure.
Yeah.
Why not?
Sounds fantastic.
Shut up, nerds. We get it.
With all you guys. Are we to drink?
It's Christmas!
explain. Black Beetle cream seats in the Regal, rocking John Lennon lenses, like to see him spread eagle.
Side effects of Maripex may include swelling of the hands and feet, constipation, trouble sleeping, or increased urination.
I note the obvious differences in the human family. Some of us are serious, some thrive on comedy. I've sailed upon the seven seas and stopped in every land. I've seen the wonders of the world, not yet one common man. I know 10,000 women called Jane and Mary Jane. I've not seen any two who really were the same. Mirror twins are different, although their features jibe, and lovers think quite different thoughts while lying side by side. I note the obvious differences between each sort and type, but we are more alike, my friends, than we are unalike. We are more alike, my friends, than we are unalike.
What are you doing?
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 Look at this dude. Wait till you see the... No. Ah, look at the top of his head.
Hello, Internet Adventurer. I am the Internet Genie. You've been giving out personal information on the internet, haven't you, boy? Take a look on the other side.
I'd like your information, please.
Do you see now what happens when you give out your personal information on the internet? You could have your identity stolen, your life taken from you in a metaphorical way, but you'll, like, have credit problems and insurance is going to be a hassle. Remember, kids, don't give out personal information on the internet, be it your password, your name, your home address, credit card information. Just don't do it. It ain't cool, or you'll end up like this schmuck. Goodbye.
What is this?
What?
This!
Heck, I don't know.
I found it on the floor in the bedroom.
It's really fabulous. I probably tracked it in on my shoe.
Okay. That's really fabulous.
Probably tracked it in on my shoe.
Oh, okay.
Thank you.
What is this?
What?
This.
Heck, I don't know.
I found it on the floor in the bedroom.
I think it's fabulous. I probably tracked it on my shoe.
Oh, okay.
I think 56 nights crazy. I think 56 nights crazy. I think me and
Wait, why are you screaming?
Hey, stay in school.
Why do you care?
Thank you.
Hello!
Cam, wake up. Nick? Nick?
What's going on?
Turn up the Mon frequencies.
Aha!
Yeah, right?
Gentlemen, one of the subjects has escaped. We need to find him as soon as ASAP.
Dream control or something. Let's just try to turn this up. What the heck?
Is it just me or is it cold in here?
It's just you.
Dude, what are you doing?
There's a fly, dude!
There is no fly!
Thank you. disappear. Where'd she go? Well, what if I...
Guys? Are you there?
Sure. Yeah, yeah.
Nate?
Yeah,
it's here. So dark. Nick?
We're here. I got a light. Hold on. Guys, is that a glove? No!
Where are we? What is this?
Let me get a light out.
Do you hear that?
Hear what?
They're burying us. You can hear it.
I can't hear anything.
I can't breathe. The oxygen.
Oh my gosh.
When you get buried alive, you don't have any control. We're stuck. We're stuck
Pat,
in here.
Oh help. My god. Sister yelling for help.
We're stuck in line. Help us! What is
help.
It? Help!
Wait, dude, why is my leg so
I'm
wet?
Peeing. I'm peeing! Oh I'm god, so scared
stop,
we're buried alive.
Help,
I can't
help.
Breathe. Get
why
us out
is
of
there
here.
So
I need
much.
Help. Oh
help
my god.
Help. Help!
Help
me!
Help! I'm so
There's
buried
so
alive.
So much
No. No.
What?
We're home. I'm home. Steve. He's home. Dad. No. Brooke, lock the door.
No, Cameron, look.
No.
I'll just go talk to him.
No one can talk to him.
Cam.
No.
You got an F on your stats test?
Dad, I suck at stats. Don't call Miss Taylor, please.
Steve, it's okay. Seriously.
Shut up. I'm not talking to you.
Bro, do you see how high we are?
What are you talking about? Look at all the water. We're gonna drown.
Gotcha!
Oh, I thought it was the subject.
The subject? What subject?
The subject we're looking for.
Let's change subjects.
Change subjects? How about the Kambambalambos?
The Kambambalambos?
No, the Kambambalambos.
What are you... No, Kambambalambalambos.
No, the... Don't you know anything?
I thought I did.
Oh.
Hey, what? Let's look for the subject.
Okay.
Hey, Eric. I'm turning that down. Maybe if I move this to terminate, I'll wake up and then.
Thank you.
neighbor.
Oh, I didn't know they sold the house.
Yeah, we just moved in. Where do you live?
The house down there on the corner.
Oh, great. Well,
I'll see you. Yeah.
People were always telling me how much they hate Ohio and how they want to move out. And after hitting 18, I catch myself saying the same thing. I start to ask myself, what am I even doing here? I'll sit in my room on Instagram seeing these amazing places people go to, and I ask myself, why can't I go to these places? Why do I have to be stuck here? Stuck here dreaming of the day where I finally leave the state with giant corn statues. And being in a high school where my teachers talk down on me for all my grades instead of looking at my actual talents, it has me counting down the days. And I can't help but look up in the sky and daydream about the day I finally hop on that plane and see Columbus for the very last time.
Thank you.
Traveling to a new place is fun and all, but eventually you start to realize you're homesick. See, I've been here before. After moving from Fox Meadow Apartments, I learned that you will miss your home. You'll miss your friends, you'll miss your family, and who knows, you might even miss those corn statues. The point is, there may never be times like these again, so enjoy what you have now at this very moment, because it might slip away before you even know it.
Thank you. just wish that when I pass out, I would just black out and not see anything.
Like, if I didn't see what I saw.
What do you see?
That's what's so frustrating. I see life, like, life goes on, like, normal. And then I wake up and none of it actually happened. Like, I'm typing up an essay. And I finish the essay and I close the laptop. And I get up. And I walk away. And then I wake up and my face is on the keyboard. And I hadn't even started. You know, like, it's just frustrating. Or I'm walking down a hallway, and I start at the beginning of the hallway, and I get to the end, and then all of a sudden I'll wake up, and I'm on the ground, in the middle of the hallway, people are hunched over me. So it's like, my mind makes up. It makes up a reality that doesn't actually happen, but I still see it anyways. I guess it's less frustrating as it is scary. I'm starting to blur the lines between what's real and what my mind's making up. I'm starting to lose grasp of reality.
What are you doing to cope?
I don't know. I'm trying, but I just can't do this anymore.
Them attacked by a tiger.
A tiger taped to a bear.
Yes, yes.
This is no laughing matter, gentlemen, okay? If they die in those dreams, they die in real life.
Oh, sorry, sir.
Oh, but wouldn't it be neat?
Oh, it would, though.
Thank you.
right, thank God. Oh my God. Eric. Oh, thank you, Eric.
Now, who left this on?
What are... Eric! Are you trying to kill us? What are you doing?
Did I see her in a dream?
What are you...
Look at your wall right now.
You and Nick are best friends.
What are you... Open it up. What are you... Nick, he's right.
Fanny packs?
What are you doing?
Stop. Eric, what did you do to them?
Guys, I'm telling you, Eric is an alien. They walk among us. Eric, as soon as I flex out of these, I'm gonna beat your face in.
Get away.
You don't even eat meat.
What are you talking about?
Yesterday, you guys had hamburgers at the park.
Why the hell would I do that, Eric? Karen, he's right. We did have burgers yesterday.
Eric, what about me, bro?
You do 50 pull-ups for a warm-up. Scott, you're not even wearing the same clothes. This has to be a dream.
What are you doing? Hey, give that back.
Remember D&D? Do you remember this one? You got on your fourth campaign, Wizard of Cost Confrontation Candlekeep.
God.
Attention, you may remove your gowns and return to the waiting room to receive your money. Thanks for your participation, subjects.
Well, boys, the results are in. 8 out of the 13 subjects were successful in saving their peers.
Which attempts led to failure?
Well, many were discovered as they ventured out of the control room, but most of the failures simply ran out of time.
Ran out of time? We gave them 4 extra minutes.
That was a slow train.
Regardless, gentlemen.
Oh, Eric, honey, did you have a little nightmare?
Good
morning, doctor.
Oh, that White Castle really gets to me.